Recall that triglycerides were broken down in the small intestine into fatty acid chains. Short and medium chain triglycerides can go straight into the blood, but the larger fats cannot because they don't transport well in the watery blood. So they must be packaged up and made ready to handle that watery blood. Long chain fatty acids are made back into triglycerides and combined with bile, known as micelles, to help them enter the lymphatic system. This graphic shows an overview of the two systems. The lymphatic system is designated as a light pink or peach color. Fats will be packaged up in the lymphatic system. Eventually, the nutrients in the lymphatic system will enter the bloodstream near the heart. Those nutrients will join the others in the blood so they can be pumped to all the cells of the body. Once the fats are absorbed into the lymph, a complicated process of transport begins. Once in the lymphatic system, the triglycerides and other fats will be packaged as lipoproteins. The first lipoprotein is the chylomicron. It will travel through the lymphatic system until it is dumped into the blood. The chylomicron will then carry fats to cells so that they can grab whatever triglycerides they need. Whatever is left over after the cells take the triglycerides from the chylomicron will be taken back to the liver. In the liver, the leftover remnants from the chylomicron plus any fats made by the liver will be packaged as a lipoprotein carrier called VLDL, known as very low density lipoprotein. The liver makes cholesterol, as we learned previously, and triglycerides. The question is, what triggers the body to make them? From research, we know that high amounts of saturated and trans fat are made into cholesterol. High intakes of overall fat and carbohydrate are made into triglycerides. So this liver is going to take any fats, whether returned to the liver or created in the liver, and package them as VLDL. VLDL enters the bloodstream to carry the lipoprotein to cells. Just like with the chylomicron, the cells will take triglycerides to use for energy and storage. As the cells remove triglycerides, the VLDL becomes smaller and more dense. These are now called LDL, low-density lipoproteins. So VLDL and LDL are basically the same thing. It started as the VLDL made in the liver, and it becomes LDL as the lipoprotein becomes smaller and more dense. The LDL will continue circulating through the blood and liver. LDL and VLDL are both known as bad cholesterol. As you can see, they are not just cholesterol, but carriers of cholesterol. It is the LDL and VLDL that contribute most to plaque buildup in the blood vessels. There is one more type of lipoprotein carrier, HDL, or high-density lipoprotein. HDL is often called the good cholesterol. As you can see, it is really not just cholesterol, but a carrier of cholesterol and other lipids. HDL is referred to as good because it removes fat and cholesterol from the body. There is some evidence that HDL may remove cholesterol from existing plaque, thus reversing heart disease, but more research is needed. The liver makes cholesterol, so the question is, how do we increase HDL? Niacin supplements have the best effect on increasing HDL, but comes with risk and should only be used if prescribed by a physician. Exercise is the next best way and comes with many other benefits important to heart disease as well, like lowering blood pressure, lowering weight, and improving cardiovascular system. While having high HDL is important, the main focus is on lowering LDL to prevent risk of heart disease. So when we look in your blood, just seeing the total cholesterol in the blood is not enough. We need to see the breakdown of the lipoprotein carriers. So let's do a quick recap of what we just learned. The cholesterol we eat is all the same. There is no good or bad cholesterol. It is only what happens to the cholesterol in your liver and how it is packaged into a lipoprotein carrier that makes it good or bad. Again, cholesterol in your food is all the same. What happens to it in the body, how it's packaged and transported, is what makes it good or bad. There's little effect of cholesterol that you eat, dietary cholesterol, on overall blood LDL levels, i.e. there is not a huge effect from dietary cholesterol increasing LDL cholesterol. The liver makes triglyceride and cholesterol from excess saturated fat and carbohydrates. As a matter of fact, refined carbohydrates are believed to have a bigger effect on triglyceride than other carbs. The fat the liver makes has the biggest effect on LDL carrying cholesterol in the blood.